I've been using obsidian for 3 years now, and the best way I can describe it is that my obsidian is a garden. I'm the gardener, and my ideas are the flowers or the herb or the vegetable, whatever it is that you're planting in your garden. The thing that you nourish, those are the ideas. And maybe you start off building your garden, you're worrying about all sorts of things. Oh, I have to plant the right thing at the right time. Oh, you know, I have to give enough space for my plant or my idea to grow in the right way. But as every gardener knows, the more you spend time with these plants, the more time you spend with your ideas, you realize actually they want to thrive and survive. I don't have to take so much care. All I need to do is give them some basic place to stay and they will thrive and they will grow a life of their own. So in my obsidian, I've started to see my ideas grow without a perfect structure. I still don't have a perfect structure. My structure is pretty much the same as the one I told you about 3 years ago. But the ideas themselves have a force in them that they want to be expressed. They tell me which direction I should explore with the books I'm reading, the podcasts that I'm trying to figure out, the topics that I'm interested in. And, you know, magically, you can't help but want to put bouquets together. You know, you see this beautiful idea here, and you see this beautiful idea there. You just can't help but want to, you know, pick them up and put them into a bouquet and show it at least to yourself, if not to others. And it's the same with ideas. Is the more you have ideas hanging around you, the more you want to express them, write about them, right? Create new notes to describe what the connections are, and even to publish publicly, like I do on YouTube, like I do on my Substack. And if this sounds really wholesome, well, it is. This is gardening for my brain. I can't find a more meditative and intellectual thing to do at the same time. I think a lot of people DM me, ask me, hey, can you help me set this up? Am I doing this right? And after 3 years of doing it, I can tell you, if you can't, even if the structure is not perfect, even if you don't know all the shortcuts, even if you're not using all the plugins, if you still find it helpful to put your ideas down into Obsidian, to look at them and to think about the ideas, then you're doing it right. Really, there's no wrong way of doing it. I remember Nick, Milo and I, we hung out in Los Angeles, I don't know, last year? I can't remember. But, you know, he was talking about structure must be earned. And I truly agree with him. Especially if you're starting Obsidian now, you don't need any sort of, what is the perfect structure? You know, I cannot start putting my ideas in it until I have the perfect structure. There is no perfect structure. What I did was, literally, there was no structure. I just put an idea I was reading. I think I started with this fictional book I was reading, and I just took down quotes. I took photos of the book. I wrote down quotes from the book, and I wrote what I thought about them. That's it. And because they were all from the same book, my first few notes, naturally they connected to each other. So I just connected quotes from a book to each other. Like, how silly does that sound? But that's how I started. The true power came when I kept on coming back to it, when I kept on tending my garden, when I kept on planting new flowers and just see what happens. Where does it lead me? You know, sometimes I would find, oh, this flower and this flower, they, you know, I see similarities I didn't see before. Until I put them down into words, I couldn't see the similarities before. Sometimes I would just randomly force two flowers together and see, oh, you know, everyone said this color combo is terrible, but I don't know, I kind of see a beauty in it. And yeah, if you're curious about obsidian, if you ever feel like, you know, there's so many of these ideas, I'm reading a book, I get all these aha moments, epiphanies, but how come when I close the book, all of a sudden those things disappear, you know, like I don't feel like they stuck in my mind. If you feel like that, just start writing down notes somewhere, anywhere. Right? If you like to write physical notes and you don't digitize them, that's okay. Right? Just write them down somewhere. I think after 3 years, I was thinking about doing an updated version of my tutorial, but Instead, I decided to do write a love letter to Obsidian using Zettelkasten. Like it's just made my life more wholesome. It's really made me happy. I kind of find it silly that, you know, people ask me, oh, you haven't posted any more videos about Obsidian. Are you not using it anymore? I'm not posting about Obsidian because I still use it, and I still use the same things that I did 3 years ago. And yeah, I probably removed even more things than I used to. It's just a place where I put my ideas and I connect between those ideas. Like that's it. If I had to give some how-tos, I would say don't do these three things. Number one is don't prejudge your idea. I've talked about this before and I strongly believe in it, which is just if something speaks to you about an idea, just write it down. I know a lot of people say, oh, you know, the quality of your ideas, you have to keep it pristine. Otherwise, it will bring down the level of your second brain. I don't think so. I think we grow, our knowledge expands, and we know more things. So we should allow ourselves some time to grow into some of the ideas that we intuitively know are beautiful or important in some way, but we can't intellectually express. So I have so many notes where, you know, I wrote it down at the time. I don't know what I was feeling, but when I come back to it again, I was thinking, wow, how come I didn't expand on this? Now I have so many things I want to say about this idea. So that's number one. No, don't prejudge your idea. If you want to write it down, just write it down. The second thing is don't manage your life in Obsidian. I mentioned Obsidian as a garden to me. It's not my life. It is just the garden of my house. I still do all of the things I need to do every single day, but I don't do it in my garden for a specific reason, because it is hard working with ideas. It's so easy to procrastinate, to distract ourselves, to do something easier, like just flick through my phone and think about something else, or not think at all. So this is why I intentionally design my Obsidian to be very basic. I don't have it. I don't have the calendar app anymore. I don't write down any to-dos unless they are related with ideas. And when I'm in here, I'm focused on output, but I'm not focused on all of the project management that comes with doing output. I am just here to write, and that's it. The third thing is, if you're starting Obsidian fresh, or if you're at the beginning stages, don't worry about recording everything you know so far. It's impossible to really record all of those things. And you can start experiencing the power of connecting your ideas just by starting small. Like I said before, I just took the book I was reading and just started writing down some quotes that resonated with me. What you want to do is to enjoy the process, I think. And doing the boring task of let me import all my quotes, let me import everything else before I can start, that delays the stance, the serious stance of you're going to face your ideas and you're going to let them grow into something else. Eventually, you know, the good ideas, you can't escape them. They will come back to you. And you'll realize, oh yeah, I read about it in this book I used to read. And you'll flip it open and you'll write down whatever it is that you wrote down before. You'll go into Readwise and you'll pull it in by yourself when is the right time. So a very different video format. I just really felt like sharing what it's really like using Obsidian. It's just, you can't do this the wrong way. Not really. As long as you enjoy the ideas, the structure will come, right? The perfect system, you don't need a perfect system for it to work. I don't have a perfect system. There's still places where I get hiccups, but it doesn't matter. Like, they don't bother me because I get to work on my ideas. I get to create output a lot easier, a lot faster, and in a lot more enjoyable way. That's it. I'll see you in the next video. Bye.